Hey everyone, Liam from AdButler here. Today we're going to go over the assignment page, where some of our most powerful features are. Before I get any further, if you're looking for information on something specific, you can find timestamps in our description below. They'll take you to targeting, they'll take you to the pacing section, if that's what you're looking for. Moving on. The assignment page is where we set the properties of a banner or campaign and how we want AdButler to serve it. It's where you find things like targeting, priority, weighting, and a whole bunch of other features. To get to the assignment page, you need to assign a campaign or banner to a zone. So I'll go into my campaign AdButler campaign and click Assign to Zone. Now we have a list of all compatible zones on the screen, and a zone is compatible if it's the same type and size as the campaign you're within. I'm going to hit this check mark here, which will take me to the assignment page for this zone. Now keep in mind, all the settings I'm about to go over are unique to this campaign zone relationship, so any changes I made aren't going to affect the other zones or campaigns that might be related to these two. Now, the assignment page is broken down into a bunch of different sections, and I'm going to be going over them one by one. Each section allows you to do some pretty different things, and although I'm going to spend time on each, I usually find it makes more sense if you mess around with it yourself, so maybe follow along with me while I do it. Okay, so to start, we have expiration and pacing. This is where we can limit our banner or campaign to a specific date range or quota. So if this campaign was to run for a month, say the month of July, I put the starting date as July 1st and the end date as July 31st under the date range. Now if we're outside of the date range, say it's still June, it's August, it's December, whatever, the banner or campaign won't serve. However, if we are within July, the campaign or banner will serve. Similarly, if I enter in a quota of impressions or clicks, say 10,000 impressions, once this quota gets hit, the banner campaign will stop serving. So if we're at 9,999 impressions, serves one more time, and then it's going to stop serving because it hit that quota of 10,000 impressions. I can also set a quota and date range at the same time, which means the banner campaign will stop serving once either it's outside the date range or the quota is hit. If you're doing something like this, we actually have a really handy feature called Smooth Delivery. Smooth Delivery sets a per second partial quota based on the date range and full quota, spreading it out so that all the impressions or clicks aren't used up on one day. If the quota is really important and you're using Smooth Delivery, you can also change the under delivery option to continue serving past the date range if the quota isn't met. So, if I were a blog and I sold a spot for a month and guaranteed 30,000 impressions, I can turn on Smooth Delivery and let AdButler know I need this banner served. And if it hits its impression numbers, great. And if it doesn't, to keep serving it past the month. Okay, so that's expiration and pacing. Moving on, we have priority and weighting, which are used to determine the chance of a banner or campaign serving. Priority is a tiered system where AdButler will always serve something in a higher tier if it can. If most of a zone's campaigns are tier 4, standard, and one campaign is tier 5, sponsorship, the sponsorship campaign will always serve unless something tells it not to. Now that can be unique delivery, it can be a date quota, it can be a bunch of different things, but if everything else is equal, the sponsorship tier will always serve over the standard tier. This is great if you have house banners, so you only want to serve them if the rest of your advertising inventory is used up. You can set it as the lowest tier, and then it will only serve when other things can't serve. Weighting is the chance the banner will be served, all things being equal. Basically, we take the weight of the campaign and divide it into the total weight of the zone to get the percentage chance of the campaign being served. For example, if you have one zone with 10 banners in it, and each banner has a weight of 1, 1 divided by 10 is 10%, so each banner has a 10% chance of being served. If we had 9 banners in a zone, all weight at 1 except for a final banner weight at 2, the total weight would still be 10, and the banner weight at 2 would serve at 20%, while others will still have a 10% chance of being served, because 2 into 10 is 20%. Weighting is kind of complicated, but once you wrap your head around it, it makes sense, and you can use it to give a banner a bit of a bump if it needs it. Moving on from priority and weighting, we get to our financial section. Here we can set the metrics for AdButler's reports and statistics. Although on the assignment page, these settings don't affect how the banner is served. They're only for record keeping and populating your records. With AdButler, you can set both rate-based and fixed metrics. Rate-based sums up the worth of every 1,000 impressions, or every click, or every conversion, and displays it for you at the rates that you set. So if you set it for $2 per CPM, for every 1,000 impressions you get, it'll record $2. For every 500, it'll record $1, etc. Or if you sell your banner or you're buying a banner placement at a fixed rate, you can just enter it in under the fixed rate option. Here you can put in $1,000 and I will just record this campaign as being worth $1,000 in your statistics. We can also enable publisher payout. This would allow a publisher account to see the financial statistics for a zone when they log in. You can change the rate as well. So if you're doing profit sharing or something else, you can change how much the publisher sees, whether it's 50%, 70%, or whatever. Next is activity limits, which are more granular and meant for specific scenarios. By dropping a cookie into someone's browser, we can limit them to 3 views a day or every 2 days or whatever you want by using our per user rate limiting. This is really handy if you want to make your stock rotate if a user is loading the same zone over and over. Say you're a news website or your ad is going to be on a news website. You can also here, as a whole, limit the campaign or banner to a certain number of impressions or clicks a day. I like to think of it as a sort of manual smooth delivery that's handy when hitting quotas to make sure, once again, it's not all being used up in one day. Finally, at the bottom here, we have our most powerful feature, targeting. Now, I'm going to devote an entire video to targeting, but to quickly go over it, we have pre-built platform and geographic targeting to start. You create a target, whether it's a city or a country or a specific computer type, and then select it from the drop-down here. Then, on top of that, we have keyword targeting. This is really flexible, and like I said, we're going to go over it more in depth later. But you can set it to target a specific keyword, set it to look in the URL for that keyword, set it to only appear on certain days of the week, or even pass in information from your CRM to target certain users if you have that information. You can also set it to be preferred or required, meaning if the keyword's hit, if it's preferred, it'll give the campaign or banner a higher chance of being served, or if it's required, the keyword must hit for the banner or campaign to be served. If it's not hit, it's not going to appear on the page at all. And there you go, a quick overview of AdButler's assignment page and how to control your banner or campaign. When looking at your zone, you can always see these settings listed under a campaign or banner. And you can also always go in and change them around if you want. If a partner only wants the banner to, say, show up during a certain month, you can use the date. If they only want it to show up on pages that are advertising or talking about the same thing they're trying to sell, say a hairdryer, you can use targeting for that. Or if you want to make sure this banner only gets seen a couple times a day, you can do that on the assignment page as well. So that's the video, guys. As always, feel free to leave a comment with any questions or email us to get in touch. Or if you haven't already, head on over to our website and sign up for a 30-day money-back trial and start getting your hands dirty. Also, if you are looking for videos on anything specific, leave a comment or email us your suggestion. We're always looking for more video ideas, and we love to hear from our audience. Once again, this was William from AdButler, guys. Have a good day, and thanks for watching.